Mercenaries, welcome back to the Syndicate. It's the General Osama, aka the Black Jack Bauer, BKA Scrooge McDuckets. Welcome back, mercenaries. Glad to see y'all back in the briefing room. Back in full effect here. Hope everybody enjoyed their holiday. Great Thanksgiving. Hopefully they got stuffed and, you know, took some rations back to their base with them. Glad to see that everybody's safe and doing well. Hopefully we got some Christmas gifts coming to y'all's way, mercenaries. Some nice treats for yourselves. You know, taking care of your family, handling responsibilities, obligations, all that good stuff. So look, episode number 9, QwicFyre, episode number 9. Range toolbox. Do you have one? Do you need one? Should you have one? And if you do need one, should have one, or want one, what should be in it? So let's dive right into it, Mercs. So, as you know, going to the range is not always just a hobby. It's a job. You always got to remember that. It's a job. And we're sharpening our skills, so when time comes for us to show that we have been trained, prepped, and ready to go, we got to hit the ground running. You know, we got to go like a snowball going downhill, straight avalanche, straight over the problem, back in the fight, back in the game, and you know, that's how we rock, mercenary. So let's dive right into it. So, I got my bag, or should I say my box. You don't have to go with this brand. This is a Westward, not sponsored or anything. It was free. You know we like free mercs. So, nice toolbox here. We're going to undo some goodies in here to show what we have and what you should be packing in your box. Few goodies in here, so it might be a nice lengthy video, merc. So, just get your cognac and your popcorn or your snacks ready, and let's dive right in. All right, mercs. Always got to have these mercs. Always got to have these mercs. And this is just me as a personal preference. You got to have you some spare ears. So these are some Peltor Sport Shotgunners. These are just plain Janes. You know, stretch them out. Put them on. Bam. Always got to have some extra ears. And you already know what that means, mercs. If you already see that we got ears, then you already know what's coming next. Gotta have your spare set of eyes. And I don't know if you ever been to True Prep in Marietta. Check them out. Nice preparedness store. They sell firearms, other type of goodies and knickknacks for survival. Check them out. True Prep Marietta. Tell Shep that Osama sent you. So these are Walker impact resistant sport glasses. Those are run-of-the-mill glasses, $5.49. I think these are Peltor shotguns were about $7.99. So backup pair, you know, safety first. Backup pair. You never know when yours might fail or when another shooter might not have a pair. Buddy comes with you. He left his in the truck. Left him at home. Bam, look at you. Good friend, mercenary. All right, along with that, gloves. Nice pair of work gloves. Now, these are the mechanics wear. Don't have to be this brand. Don't even have to be this type of color or pattern. You know, the olive drab camo layout. But just need some gloves, mercs. Might be cold like how it is now, December. You need to stay prepped and ready. Never know what's going to happen. All right, mercs. This one here is kind of special to me. And that's because, you know, I'm the YouTuber, GunTuber, whatever you want to call me. You never know, mercs, when you might be rushing out the door. You know, you might be running late, getting to the range or shoot. Always have to have backup tripod. Backup tripod. Yes, mercs. See if we get this bad boy open. Alright. There we go. Backup tripod. Y'all already know. Wham bam. Thank you, ma'am. I just let it go, let it sit there so you can see it. Tripod. Never know when you might just need an extra one. Or yours might break. And along with that, got you some mounts. So if anybody has one that has a plate, have a spare plate, and I have the quarter by 20 thread hole pitch for the cell phone holder. You know, you're doing some shooting and you get a spare, or you got a spare camera, or someone else needs to borrow a camera. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. And since we're going to be talking about cameras, boom, here go my backup right here. Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus. Now, you don't have to use this specific one. Don't have to be Samsung. But this is my backup camera right here. So, you know, for all my people doing content creation at the range. And that's not all. Let me show you. Backup battery source. Power source. Right here. I think this is an Energizer 30,000 milliamp hour capacity battery storage. Yes, Mercs. Gotta have it. Gotta have it, Mercs. And just to let you know, we got a charger cable, and we also have this little special here, because this is a magnetic. So what you do is you buy your little magnetic adapter piece on here, put it on to your opposite end of your magnetic part that you wish to charge. And like I say, these things have the micro USB, USB-C, lightning attachment. So you can't forget about that. And other type of cord. So this is your micro USB. Another micro USB. And I think I left the USB-C upstairs for my phone. But just no mercenaries. I will throw it here in the toolbox. So look, content creators backup kit. And just in case you don't have another one, here goes another one right here, mounting hardware to put on your tripod if you have one that takes an Arca plate. So look at that, Mercs. Look at that, content creator included. Can't beat that, Mercs. And you saying, wow, it's probably just getting to the good part of this toolbox. Just tip of the iceberg, Mercs. Let's clear the desk off. All right, Mercs. Let's dive back into it. We'll stay with power sources. So, I have here, in this bag here, different type of batteries and different type of bags and containers. So, let's get on into it, Mercs. What we have here... QwicFyre batteries, and these batteries are CR120 alphas. So these go in like your range finders, things of that nature, maybe tactical light laser. So these are QwicFyre batteries. I got them on sale for $1 a piece. So I have 5 in here, and I guess I'll just take them out so y'all can see them there. 5 batteries from QwicFyre. 5 CR123 alphas. Alright. Never know what's going to happen out here in the field, Mercs. You just don't know. I got another thing of batteries here. Energizer. Double A's. Right here. I keep these in the box for the Kestrel meter, which I will gladly pull out. Bam. Kestrel meter. Gotta have this, gents. Gotta have that. That's a little part that goes on to the tripod here for the mount, for the wind vane mount, which is included in this package here. So your Kestrel takes a single AA battery. And there goes your power source. I'm just gonna grab this, Mercs. So, power source, again, taken care of. Let's show you some more power. Just in case anybody needs more, we have some run-of-the-mill Energizer Industrial AA batteries. And this is a 24-pack. Never can have too many batteries, Mercs. I usually run the lithium ion for the Kestrel. That's recommended. Because with the Kestrel, when you power it on, you can select the type of battery. And the Kestrel adjusts to the battery and gives you optimal performance life out of the battery. Food for thought. All right, Murph, let's stay with it. We got some more. Some more batteries. We got more, and these are CR2s. CR2s. So these also go in range finders, tactical lights, things of that nature. CR2 by Viridian. So these have a 10-year shelf life. Like I say, and I think these are compared to the CR123 Alphas as they have it compared on the back here. And it says up to 31% longer battery life. 3 volts. CR2s and CR123s. Don't think it's much of a difference, but I'm not an expert. All right. For most of you people who have an illuminated scope, and I mean an illuminated crosshair scope, you'll need some of these. And I'm going to see if I can show it on here. This is an Energizer CR2032 battery. This is like your common watch battery. This is what illuminates your reticle in the dark when you're shooting at night or in dim light. You're going to need some spare of these. So here goes my one spare. And I think my other spare, I put it in another scope of mine. So all my scopes have fresh batteries, but I'll keep a spare or two in the toolbox. Never know when you're going to need it, Mercs. And also, I can't remember this battery offhand. Let me see if I can look at it real quick through the package without having to take it out. I can't say it's like a CRV. A CR13 November. So this goes to the long range arm send it or the MDT send it levels. These are the batteries for those levels, electronic levels for your scope. Always at least keep one of those on standby. All right, I think that's it for power source, Mercs. I think that's it for power source, but just since we're on it, we'll just stay with it. Content creator, have my lavalier mic and a little case for it, for the mic and the transmitter. Whenever I'm out and about, mic dies, I have a thing to charge up my mic to keep my content creativity actions going. So just let's think about that, Mercs. All while I just pulled out this box so far, I still got a few more items to go. These are things that you need to keep in your box. Now we're going to get into the tools, okay? Now we're going to get into the tools. As usual, everybody should have a knife. This is just a little random buck knife, found it on the ground somewhere, made in China. But if I need to get into something, this should be able to at least give me a fighting chance to open up some type of stiff plastic packaging. So always think about that, Mercs. Tools. I'm a spur man. So what I have here, in case I need to re-level or someone else has a spur kit or another type of scope that needs to be mounted. I want to say this only works for spur, but I haven't been adventurous to try it on someone else's mount. Maybe I tried on one of my own, but this is a scope wedge to make sure that your scope is level if you have to take it out the rings. So gotta have your tools, Mercs. Gotta have your tools. That's just the tip of the iceberg with the tools. All right. And for my precision rifle, I always keep backup magazines. Always keep backup mag. These are 210 round, 30 caliber, 6.5 Creedmoor, 6mm Creed, 6.5 Lapua magazines. Each of these hold 10, and they're detachable box magazines. Must have. Never can have too many magazines in your precision bolt gun. For my people running cans, can gets extra hot. I know this is probably, you're already laughing. I know you're laughing, but scope should not the scope. So look, I'm running too fast, Mercs. Suppressor mitt. I'm always thinking about Ezra. I'm going to say the silencer shot suppressor mitt. Got to have one of these to help add to the safety of taking your can off. You know, it doesn't have the best heat blocking properties, but if you have a scope, I keep saying scope, Mercs. If you have a suppressor cover on your can, and the heat has been going through that, depending on your rate of fire, what you're shooting, just a little extra grip and protection to help get that can off, you know, it'd be great. Now, if you just have a bare can with no cover, this will go right through and the heat will burn you. So I'm just let you know now. I have a few of these. I gave one away. I think I might give another one away. Silence the shop. The number one suppressor transfer or suppressor shopping company in the country. You know, if your FFL SOT Class 3 dealer isn't plugged in with Silencer Shop, or at least E-Silencers, Silencer Central, Capital Armory, any of those, but preferably Silencer Shop, the OGs in the game, get with them. Suppressor cover. It's optional, but if you're shooting cans or know someone who does, just keep a little extra lifeline there for them. All right? Tools. Bam, Mercs. Look at this here, Hyper Tough 44-piece precision screwdriver bit set. Never know when you might have to take something apart, Mercs. And you know, sometimes when you have little small things you're making adjustments on, we'll use, for example, PET 15, civilian or full power, or ultra high power. To make your adjustments, you have to unleash those screws on there in order to adjust your dials on your illuminator and your laser. So this little toolkit comes in handy. My little, Luna ELIR-3 adjustments take these small little, I'm gonna say it's the H2 or H1.5 hexagonal bit, 1.5 millimeter bit to make my adjustments to zero my IR illuminator at my distance. So these really come in handy, Mercs. Really come in handy. And also, the holy grail of toolkits right here, Mercs. This is it right here. Fix-It sticks. Your gun range kit is not complete without one of these. Tool-wise, and I'm not talking about cleaning kit. Tool kit. So y'all know I run the Vortex Razor Gen 3, 6-36. This is the multi-tool for the Vortex. I have yet put the multi-tool in for the Night Force yet, but that will be going in here soon. And bam, Fix-It sticks. And we have different type of torque. So we have fixed torque wrenches right here. This is the 49-inch pound. You have 49-inch pound slot key. That's for your for my Accuracy International. When I'm doing a quick barrel change, it asks for 49 foot-pounds of torque to lock the quick lock retention screw. And this here is a 25-inch pound. Torque limiter for usually for scope mounts. So you know you don't want to over torque your mount on your scope and have it have the indention on the body. And for those who really just need a jack of all trades, we have a universal one here that goes from 0 pounds to 65-inch pounds. So anything that needs to be torqued, this is the guy for the job. And like I say, here go our sticks here. Don't mind those, I grab them. And they come in all different type of bits, all right? So what I would do, if I wanna use, take that out, put it in here. So now I have like a little T-handle. And what I would do, for shits and giggles, let's just say I wanna, and I'm just gonna use it even though it's saying the right type of, bit for the mount, but we'll just say I need to torque on rings on the scope. We already have the base already mounted on the rail. Now we have the scope and the rings on the mount, and now we just need to torque them to spec. And what you do, you put it on, turn it, and what you need to do is have it to where you put it in, and when you turn it, you can see the numerical value in front of you to know when you have reached your specific torque in inch pounds to know that when you know reach the value that you're looking for, and it locks in, it doesn't snap or anything. So all you do on this one is you just turn it till it gets to the value you want, and that's it. But the other ones, they're already set. So you just turn it till you hear it click, and you can turn it till you hear it click again, just to double check, and wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, you're in the game, just like that. Like I said, man, man's best friend. If you have a quick change barrel system, a precision gun, or gas gun with a scope on it, that might be a quick change barrel system. Also, if you have like a LMT Mars H, something like that, this would be the perfect tool for you. Perfect tool for you. So that's it, Mercs. Range toolbox. I think that every mercenary should have one. And if you don't, you need to get one. Thank y'all for tuning in, mercenaries. Thank y'all. I hope everybody has enjoyed the video. We're going to have another QwicFyre episode 10 coming out pretty soon. And thank y'all again for your unwavering support. And as always, thank you for rocking with the General. Thank you very much. And as always, stay safe, stay legal, stay dangerous, stay prepared, stay informed. Osama is out.